In this tutorial, I'll show you how to model, texture and render a photorealistic treasure chest. To follow along, you need to activate an add-on called, Add Curve, Extra Objects, that can be found under, Edit, Preferences, and Add-ons. I'll post a link to this tutorial's reference images and PBR material files in the description below. Let's create a cube and scale it like this. We need to remove this face. We could either duplicate this edge loop and work on the cover or slice the cylinder mesh in half with a knife tool. We'll see what we'll use as we progress along. In object mode, let's reset scale after pressing Ctrl plus A. Press E to extrude, Enter to settle and S to scale inward. We need to move this edge loop down on the Z axis. Let's select these faces. The pivot should be individual origins. This won't work. Let's scale them separately. Let's extrude along normals inward. Let's create a new cube and subdivide it. We need to scale it and add loop cuts to make the edges look sharper. Let's create a keyhole using a curve point. We need to create a curve point and press the 3D button. Let's extrude the curve point. Please remember to set the last point's X to 0. We need to select the sharp edge point and press V and A to turn it into a smooth edge like this. Let's mirror it and convert it to mesh. We can knife project the keyhole. Let's extrude inward. Let's go to Object Data, Normals, and Auto Smooth to fix the normal issue. Let's create a new cylinder to create the chest cover. We can scale it like this and slice it in half using a knife tool. While using the knife tool, we need to press Z to cut through and C to straight. Let's select this edge and press Shift S to move the 3D cursor here. Let's tab to go to Object Mode and move the origin to the 3D cursor. Let's rotate the chest cover. We can follow the same steps to extrude these side faces inward. Let's create a ground mesh. We could either use a texture to create a bumpy ground or use a PBR material. Let's click this node and press Ctrl, Shift and T to load the PBR images. Let's select displacement and bump. Let's create a coin with a cylinder. Let's export the UV layout. Let's open the UV layout and the coin image in Photoshop and copy and paste the coin image to the UV layout image's second layer. Let's scale the coin image down to match the size. Please remember to turn off the UV layout layer before saving. Let's apply the UV layout image to the coin mesh. Let's apply the array modifier. We need 300 of them. Let's undo and apply the rigid body first. For coins, we need rigid body active, and for the rest of the meshes, we need rigid body passive. Let's press P to separate by loose parts. Let's add them to a new collection called coins. Let's set the origin to geometry and play the animation. This is not enough. Let's duplicate 4 more. Let's play the animation. This is good enough. Why do I have 4 locks now? Let's apply new materials for the chest. We can reset the UV. Let's rotate and scale the UV. We need a light source. Let's create a plane and use emission shader with a strength of 8. Let's leave it as displacement and bump. Let's play the animation once again. Let's render the scene. My hard drive ran out of recording space while recording this part. As you can see, the ground mesh's render was not done well. What I have done to fix that was lowering the ground mesh's normal map strength to 1, and rendering the chest and the ground separately. This was the treasure chest render. This was an updated ground mesh render. This is the end of the treasure chest tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.